I'm here with Paul Shellard from the National Education Union. We're here for the vote, and you're secretary, aren't you, of the branch? Is that the Brighton branch?
Yeah, it's the Brighton branch of the National Education Union. We represent somewhere between 80 and 85% of teachers who work in Brighton and Hove schools.
And we're here to talk about Moulsecoomb Primary School. Maybe just update us about where we are with the proposed academisation of the school first, and then we can talk about the strike.
Well, what's happened recently is that eventually a sponsor has been announced, and that has meant that we've had a ballot for strike action, and that ballot was very successful, unanimous vote, 100% in favour of taking strike action. So there's that's likely to take place on the 21st of November, and that is about protecting the pay and conditions and jobs, which the academisation is a threat towards.
So going back to the strike on 21st of November, that people might say that's going to impact the pupils at the school. So I guess what's your response to that?
Well, strike action is bound to impact. We wouldn't be taking strike action unless there was an impact. But I think what we have to accept is, first of all, there is massive support in the community for us taking strike action. Yeah. Parents have already said they want to join stuff on the picket line. They're already kind of organising activities to make sure the children, for those who have parents who work, can be entertained and looked after on that day. So there is that community support, because they recognise that it's one of the few measures that staff can take to show that they want to protect the school's position and their pay and conditions. But in some ways, the very limited disruption that will take place on that day is very small compared to the massive disruption that the school is facing as a result of being forced to be an academy. So it's really to stop that disruption and the way that it's preventing the school from, or interrupting the school from its journey of improvement.
What needs to happen in state schools across the country to improve funding? Is it, I mean, it's kind of a forced choice in a way, but is it the buildings, or is it kind of more teachers and kind of smaller classes? Or is it that's probably a false dichotomy?
It is. Yeah. It is. It's all of those things. What's needed is a massive injection of funding, because since 2010, billions of pounds have been taken out of education. And even what's been supposedly promised by Boris Johnson recently would only really take schools back a couple of years. It wouldn't even kind of repair the damage that's been done since 2016.
So, is there any hope of that situation changing? I mean, what would you do? I know we're coming up to a general election. We don't want to be talking about party politics, but as a whole, what do you think needs to happen then? What should be a new government's priority, whoever that government might be?
A new government's priority must be to invest billions of pounds more in education, because it's children's right to have that investment. And I suppose in the last election, what was clear is that more and more people were using their vote partly as a response to education as an issue. It was one of the top issues in the last general election, and we expect it to be this time, because there's been no improvement and parents can clearly see that a lot of the issues can't be addressed by schools at the moment. They're doing the best that they can, but they're doing the best they can with very limited resources. Yeah. So there needs to be a commitment from all political parties to invest in education properly.
Just before we go, and very briefly, do you see this changing? Do you think education is going to be a big issue in the forthcoming election?
I do. I accept that there will be other issues that will be prominent as well.
Yes.
But parents, I think, recognise from their own experience and the experience of their children that education funding primarily is an important issue. And in the last election, there were many seats, MP seats, which we think were decided on by people voting according to what the parties were putting forward on education. So school cuts was a big political issue. Yeah. We think that will be the same this time.
Perfect way to end. So, Paul, thanks for coming in today, and all the best for the future.
Thank you.